Before we can talk about how to determine when a shoe is worn out, we really want to understand a little bit about the anatomy of a shoe. So the first part of a shoe's anatomy that we're going to be interested in or talking about is the upper. The upper is this part of the shoe. It's everything that wraps around your foot. It's the part that has the mesh, it's the part that has the eyelets, and the other important part of the upper that we'll be talking about is called the heel counter. The heel counter is actually this part of the shoe. It's the back part of the shoe. Running shoe companies oftentimes will put a firm piece of plastic in the heel counter to help prevent pronation, to help land the foot at heel strike. So that's another important part of the shoe. The second part of the shoe is the lower. The lower consists of the midsole, which is this material right here. The midsole is either a softer material, which is white or lighter, or a firm material, which is usually gray or darker. The midsole provides cushioning and shock absorption. The last part of the lower is the outsole. The outsole is usually this black rubber part. It is firm, it's durable, it imparts longevity, lifespan, and wear to the shoe. So this is something that we're going to really want to pay attention to when we look at how to evaluate when your shoes are excessively worn. One of the first areas to show wear in a running shoe is the outsole. The outsole, especially in the forefoot area. This shoe shows us the blue is the outsole. It's the firm shell that's designed to impart durability. In this case, the runner has actually worn through the outsole into the midsole. Now, the midsole is never designed to be durable. It's pumped full of air, it's soft, it's cushioned, it's shock absorptive, but without the outer covering, without the outer outsole, it just bottoms out and it destroys the shoe quickly. So this is an instance where the outsole has worn laterally. This shoe actually shows us a different wear pattern in the outsole. This one you can see it's more central. The waffle pattern of the shoe has actually a height to it. And when you strike on the forefoot repeatedly, then you start to wear through the outsole thickness. And again, just like we saw in the prior shoe, once you start to lose some of that rigidity, some of that firmness of the outsole, then you're in the soft midsole and then the shoe starts to fall apart. This is another example of a worn outsole in the forefoot. Here, if you press, I mean, this is paper thin. This person's joints are right next to the pavement. And this person was having some ball of foot pain, not surprisingly. So not only do you want to look at how much of the outsole is worn in terms of how it's become thin, you want to press on it and see, is it as firm here as it is here? If you have a reduction or a loss of firmness and all of a sudden that becomes so thin that you can poke right through, then it's time to replace the shoe. This outsole is similar to the first one, and this shoe just, when I was talking about earlier about you can't use 6 months or 500 miles, this shoe actually wore this way in a matter of 4 weeks, and it was symmetrical. This is crazy because this little thin cap of outsole wasn't enough to cushion, or wasn't enough to protect the cushioning midsole of this shoe. This shoe is toast at this point. Now we'll talk about the upper a little bit. A lot of times I'm asked, what happens if you poke through the mesh? Well, that's really not a problem. As long as the inner and outer parts of the upper stay intact to the midsole, then you're fine. If you wear through the upper, if your toe comes out, if you wear through where you've got a bunion, that's not a problem whatsoever. The next area of the upper you want to evaluate is the heel counter. When you place a shoe on a flat surface, like a table, the heel counter should be a bisection through the center of that heel counter should be perpendicular to the table. So in this case, this is a new shoe. This Brooks is indeed, the counter is perpendicular to the flat surface of the table. If we go over to the next shoe, we can actually see how it's tilting. Instead of straight, it's tilting inward. And the same thing with this one. The minute your shoe starts to tilt either inward or outward, that's a sign that you need to replace the shoe. Because when the shoe breaks down, in this case medially, the medial part of the heel has compressed compared to the lateral, the shoe's actually holding you in the improper alignment, and that can spell trouble faster than anything. This area shows you the inside of the heel counter. This has worn clean through. A lot of patients, especially who are really supinated at heel strike and then pronate to get their forefoot to the ground, wind up wearing through the inside part of the counter inside the shoe. This is crazy because it's actually got a plastic counter, and this runner's actually split it. So I'm surprised, frankly, that this person didn't develop a blister or a laceration due to the sharpness cutting through his heel. So one of the things that you want to make sure is not only to check the outside of the shoe, but to check the inside of the shoe, particularly in the counter area. Another feature of the midsole that we want to check is comparing the right to the left. In this case, what we want to do is we want to compare how much the right forefoot flexes compared to the left forefoot flex, and then we want to check twist. Twist, another name for twist is torsional stability, which is the side-to-side motion that the shoe makes. So in this case, the right shoe has a lot of forefoot flex, and it has a lot of torsional instability. The left shoe, on the other hand, has less forefoot flexion and less torsional instability. So what we can determine from the right shoe versus the left shoe for this patient is the right shoe is quite a bit more worn than the left, and so when that happens, we're going to want to replace the shoe.